Hey guys, here we are back on Wind Chaser. Just finished tilling up this side of the field here, over our plowed terrain. So we're just gonna putz on down the road. Cat Challenger. The main dairy farm. Dairy cows in there in the stalls and the commodity shed. Power lines going to all the buildings. Lights on at the houses. So I did the north part of this field, and I'm just going to come up and finish this other part. Really farmed this much, so it's kind of interesting on how to properly till. So we're spraying NPK while we cultivate. Just to get some moisture and nutrients back into this ground since we never harvested it yet. We also own this grassy patch here. I opted not to till it in for to a field. We're just leaving it as grass for now because it's really not worth planting. We don't have a planter small enough to even get in there. So we really can't farm it right now. The only thing we could really do is maybe eventually use it for grass and silage. But it's a pretty small, awkward little field, but it's has all kind of contours and curves, so it's, in that respect, it's pretty cool. A lot of manual planting. You can run the GPS like I am now in certain sections, but there's really no benefit to cultivating with soil mod other than you get a smoother ride on your tractors during planting. Not like it really matters when you're running 500-600 horsepower machines, but the only thing it really does is dry your soil, but you have to act like you're doing seedbed prep. You just can't plant over plowed terrain. So hopefully this field does pretty well. We picked it up pretty cheap, so new tracks look amazing. Really makes the whole tractor look a lot better with those better tracks. So this has the cab suspension, so you can see the cab just bounce all over. Just got my new AC in my apartment today. Loving life. My parents are coming up for my white coat ceremony, which symbolizes your entry into a patient clinic. That's between so basically the beginning of our third year, and planning on staying with me. And I was just like, you guys are gonna die because I don't have AC. So we're not allowed to have window units because they're concerned about how it looks and that it might fall. So anyways, I got an indoor unit. It works pretty great. Have it at 73 degrees right now. Only because all my utilities are included in my rent, so I don't have to pay for electricity. Anyways, just taking a study break. It's Saturday at about 7 o'clock in the evening, and I have another endo final on Monday morning at 10. So I'm just taking a little break, plowing up some of my fields, finishing some of my fields, I should say. has a different timing on the folding. See, the Beat Facilities lights are on. Actually, I changed my mind. Train out in the distance. Field 12 here, it's covered in grass. So this is field 15, this is the other field we picked up with when we bought 11. I didn't really have enough money to buy another big field, so we just bought two smaller ones. These fields with odd angles, they really aren't conducive to course play, but you could easily run a grain cart on course play and then just run the harvester yourself. or use Follow Me mod if you're running more than one combine. So these smaller fields, it's a little bit more fun to run manually because you're not stuck behind the wheel as long as you're just going down in a straight line. So I like to do headlands with my cultivator so I know where to stop when I get to the straight points. So these tractors, these crawler tractors with a shorter wheelbase, they like to bounce around more than their wheeled counterparts. The quad tracks, so the quad tracks are pretty solid. You get the benefits of the track plus the wide wheelbase. Really working the Krauss wings on this field. So now we just put it on auto steer. I can show you guys how to set up auto turn. You can just set this back about 4 meters or so, and then just keep your reduce my turn speed so it turns at probably like 11. And then it should be fully automatic. It will do the turning for me and Actually, I'm gonna. It's really kind of like a guesstimate to see what kind of turning it does. So if you just want to focus on lifting your implement and lowering your implement and not worrying about steering on your headlands. So we'll just do a test run and see how far it goes in before it turns, and if it's turning too late, we'll have to figure something out, but I think it should work. You can always just lower your speed, lift your tool, do its turn, lower your tool, turn your speed back up. So that one wasn't too bad. We could probably back it up to like 1.6. We should be good. So now all we have to do is lift our implement. Well, we don't even have to do that. All I'm doing now is running the mouse and not even touching the keyboard. GPS, we are always on the same line. And making sure we're getting as much coverage as possible with the cultivator and our sprayer. Maintaining your speed. Right around that 12, 11, 12 mile an hour mark. There goes the big grain train. Go ahead, lift up our tool. Slow down our tractor. Lower our tool. Speed it back up. Pretty easy. I like to slow down my tractor on the turns just so it's easier on the steering. Plus it gives time to lower the implement. If you were to just do that quick turn at like 12, 13 miles an hour, the GPS doesn't really like coming into corners that fast. So if you slow it down to a more realistic 8 or something, handles it much better. And then you just throttle it back up when you're going down, so as you really should be doing. So this tool, it has the fixed like depth control of these wheels in the front. Which controls the rear, the actual lowering gear, how low they go. So it really, you're able to adjust the depth of your tines. So it looks like we're running these pretty deep right now, probably like 6-7 inches at least. So this one we'll just do like an outdoor outside view. So we'll slow it down, lift our implement. Once it makes its turn, we'll lower the implement and increase the speed. This would make a nice cornfield, I think. Long stretches, pretty easy headlands. Just go ahead and slow this guy down a little bit. So now that we're running into these angles, it gets a little bit tricky. Doesn't really like, it needs a greater offset really. But when the headland is squared off with the lane that you're running, it works pretty well.